Hello, and welcome to Whatever Etc. number 18 for Tuesday, July 17th. This is Keith Brown. I am going to talk to you today about the boundary situation of chance. One of the things that I've really been trying to get across to people when I dialogue with them is that the five boundary situations, the five genuine conditions of our humanity, chance, struggle, suffering, guilt or regret, and death, they all sound like negative concepts to us. This is because we've come to live in a society that is obsessed with security. We've come to be so secure and so free from negative situations on the whole that we look at these five boundary situations, we look at the notions of these five boundary situations as being negative themselves, when in fact they are positive constitutive factors. They are positive factors that constitute our being human. Chance, suffering, struggle, regret, and death. Now, I want to talk today about the boundary situation of chance, and basically, when I think of chance, what I'm thinking about is a movement that's a digression. In other words, it's a movement that happens that was unexpected, something happens that was unplanned, it gets in the way. We could talk about Aristotle, or we could talk about Lao Tzu, or any number of people who've dealt with the issue of chance in some very interesting ways. But more than anything else, I really want to highlight the existential moment of chance, which is that when we're moving in a certain direction, when we're moving in a certain pattern or way, and we know where we want to go, we have a goal in mind, we have a target in mind that we're trying to hit, there often will be things that will happen that will get in our way. Something, you know, that will sideline us or sidetrack us. And that's why I say the boundary situation of chance is a digression. And as a digression, again, another one of those things that can have a kind of negative tone to it. But basically what we're talking about with digression is a break in motion, a break in the motion that you're moving through. It's not a break in motion itself. It doesn't mean the breakdown of motion. It means that wherever it is you're trying to get to, you're moved away from. Now, one of the things that's really interesting about chance, and we talk a lot in our culture about entrepreneurship, we talk a lot in our culture about seizing opportunities, is that opportunities often present themselves by chance. What we can do is we can train ourselves to recognize opportunities when they arise. We can train ourselves to recognize ventures that might pop up that were unexpected. But we have to be willing to embrace, to engage the opportunities as they arise by chance. I think one of the biggest issues at play in our society of security is that in our attempt to be secure, we've attempted to control nature, to control the basics of social exchange to such an upteenth degree that even the slightest variation can cause really major problems for us. And I don't want to say that all things that happen by chance are good, and I don't want to say that every opportunity that arises will lead to greater successes. But what I'm trying to say is that in training ourselves through various mindful contemplations, in training ourselves to attend to the world, to focus upon our situatedness, to open ourselves to possibilities, being open to possibilities is being willing to seize the digressions that occur, being willing to take up what happens to us by chance. This last weekend, I by chance had made a few, I made a few arrangements to meet with different people. I didn't know what the conversations were going to be about per se. I didn't know where the conversations were going. This to me is the Socratic moment. This to me is the anarcho-cynical moment, when we seize the possible digressions of our mind walks with others, when we seize the possible digressions of our interchanges in our dialectics. So on Saturday, I spent the morning reading and letting my mind go from Chan poetry to continental philosophy to celebrity gossip, just being all over the place and doing some postings on the blog and things. And then around 2 o'clock, I met with three wonderful young people who wanted to talk to me about Gilles Deleuze and his text on the Postscripts of the Society of Control, which anybody who runs into me a lot knows is something that I'm really big on right now. But what was interesting was having three brand new friends who are a brand new group of people who wanted to study the Deleuze and who are millennials, who are part of the millennial generation, who actually are so a part of the Society of Control, and where the conversation was allowed to go and where it went and the kinds of questions they had. Then after that, my boyfriend and I went home and had a wonderful time reconnecting with diverse television programs and pieces of literature that we hadn't looked at in a while. And then on Sunday, I met up with my my friend Andrew, and we talked about the things that he's doing in his new job, working as a production coordinator on a TV show, and we kind of mind walked hither thither and anon, and then Sunday evening went out to Dan Silverleaf here in Denton, saw In Order to Hear Hares on the Mountain, and to meet up with our friends Julia and Nick, and in meeting up with them ran into a whole host of other people that I hadn't seen in a long time. And but again, the whole point here is that it was 2 days of incredible energy, and it was 2 days of incredible energy that were mostly unplanned. They didn't go anywhere that I would have expected for them to go. The conversation with Kevin and Heather, and Kevin's roommate, whose name I've forgotten, oh my heavens, Justin, I think, we ended up in this wonderful conversation that sort of spanned 2.5 hours, and then, Chris and I re-energizing ourselves with really quality-made TV shows and quality-made literature that we love to talk about with each other. And then on Sunday, talking with Andrew and Nick and Julia and running into Joseph Carr and Jordan Batson and Becky and all of these people, Becky from The Tomato and all of these people, and getting to see them and see how they're all flourishing in their own ways and the directions that they're all going. It was a weekend of digressions. And that was beautiful. It was a weekend of boundary situations, of chance, of where I was constantly up against, what's going to happen next. And there was no insecurity, because I was not trying to keep something secure that would lead to an insecurity. There was merely concern and care for these people at the borders of meeting each other and going where we will by chance. And so I want to thank all of them for a wonderful weekend that completely re-energized and revitalized me. And I hope that they got something along the same lines out of these encounters. And I'll be talking to you next time about the boundary situations of the boundary situation of struggle. So until we meet, hopefully there won't be too many digressions in between that will keep me from getting my next podcast up sooner than the last time. I ask you to embrace tranquillitas et bonum, tranquility and goodness. Thank you very much, and I will see you hopefully in a day or two.